Action News meteorologist Greg D with a quick weather update for you this morning on what's going on this weekend. A lot could still change with this tropical system coming in. So I do want to let you know I'll be posting a lot of updates through the weekend and through today on track intensity and exactly what we're going to see. At Greg D Weather, Twitter, Instagram, check out my Facebook pages. Both will be very active through the weekend. You can also visit me on my Snapchat feed and send me and tag me any photos that you may get. This morning, we are mainly dry in Tampa. Take a look at Central Florida, just a lot of clouds moving in. But notice the showers to our east and southeast here across South Florida. This is the beginning of a moisture feed that's headed this way, and I do expect some of this rain down towards West Palm Beach and over towards Jupiter and Fort Pierce to cross the lake and start moving into our area as we go into the afternoon. More coverage of the rain too as we go through the day. Of course, all eyes down to the south, Western Caribbean, Northern Gulf of Mexico, starting to see something develop here. This little ball of convection is starting to take shape. I think there's a low pressure now that's starting to develop on the western edge of this. It's the eastern side that has the heavy rain, and that'll spread across Florida as we move into the weekend. Hurricane Center still thinks 90% chance now of this thing developing in the next 48 hours. It is expected to track north, but that eastern side of it is going to get pretty close to us as we move into the weekend. Take a look at the models. They're generally taking it north, but some of them take it first northeast and then make a turn. That turn would keep it over the water a little bit longer. Still quite a mess, but you see the focus. It's really from Panama City to New Orleans, with the highest concentration of models indicating this thing is going to head maybe towards Pensacola, Mobile, Gulfport, or maybe New Orleans. But I would say Gulfport to Mobile to Pensacola, probably most likely to see the center come close to it coming up on Monday. With that center coming onshore and some outer rain bands affecting Florida, the Storm Prediction Center has actually put us under a marginal, that's the lowest, level one risk of severe storms on Saturday. This would mainly be in the form of waterspouts along the coast, maybe a brief spin-up tornado inland. Would not be surprised to see a tornado watch issued for our coastal communities coming up either late Saturday or maybe early into Sunday morning. Today, it's just cloudy skies and moisture on the increase. If you're thinking about leaving for the weekend, earlier is better if you've got that choice, or maybe running errands and just getting out on the city, on the town, maybe picking up a couple of groceries for family gatherings, that type of thing. Do that early, because through midday, I think we're mainly dry. But look what happens by the afternoon. By 4 o'clock, numerous showers and thunderstorms already popping up. That's earlier than yesterday, and more coverage too. In fact, as we take this through the evening, there could be heavy rain all around Tampa Bay, Hillsborough, Pinellas, over towards Pasco County. It's out of here by 9, so the late evening is looking fine. Mainly cloudy overnight. Saturday starts dry. Now, this computer model is not the best at forecasting tropical systems, so it keeps most of Saturday dry. I do think Saturday from south to north, the rain will start to spread in. If you live in Sarasota, Bradenton, Arcadia, Sebring, you're most likely to have a rainy day on Saturday, whereas north of I-4, the rain may hold off really until Saturday night. Just take a look at this. We're tracking the low pressure center right there, just around Cozumel and Cancun. Early Saturday morning, the rain mainly across southwest and south Florida. It'll be trying to head up toward I-4 as we go into the afternoon and evening, but it may take some time for it to get to Tampa. So those of you north of I-4 on Saturday may actually not see any rain during the day Saturday. Tampa, maybe some scattered showers or rain developing late. South of I-4, I think you're more likely to have a wet day as that storm moves through. Saturday night into Sunday morning is the peak of the system. Notice this yellow and dark green here. That's a heavy tropical feeder band coming into the west coast of Florida from the Euro model. By this time, we could be talking about Tropical Storm Alberto out in the Gulf of Mexico. I'm just indicating it as a low pressure center here. As it moves north and northwest, those feeder bands spread inland during the day on Sunday. So basically a washout for the theme parks in Central Florida on Sunday, and even around Tampa, we could see periods of rain and light showers throughout the day, even though the actual low pressure center will be out here in the northwestern Gulf of Mexico. Notice the rain spreads all across the panhandle, even into the low country of South Carolina. So just a rainy day Sunday around the southern and southeast states. Monday, hit and miss thunderstorms during the afternoon, more coverage because of the moisture around that storm, but we could see some pockets of sunshine on Monday as well. So Saturday mainly dry, rain late developing south to north. Sunday looks pretty rainy, breezy, maybe some stronger storms in the morning in the first half of the day as that system moves through. The rest of your holiday weekend, pretty wet on Monday too, especially in the afternoon with drier air coming in late on Monday. That'll impact us by Tuesday and Wednesday. So again, Lots of updates on my social media channels throughout the weekend. There may be some significant updates. Who knows, as the system progresses, as the hurricane hunters get out there today, see what they find as they put in the actual center of the storm and locate it. They put that into the models, and then the information really starts to be more accurate. That's why I think there is still a window here, an opportunity for things to change as we head into the actual track of the storm. I don't think it's going to impact us, but just the timing of the rain and its actual location could certainly be an impact in terms of us planning the holiday weekend. All right, buddy, have a great and safe holiday weekend. I'll see you on the social medias throughout the weekend and right here for ABC Action News later on today.